Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss the mitotic cell cycle. We will cover the basics of mitosis, regulatory checkpoints, and the mechanism. Also, we will learn how this is different from meiosis. Have you ever wondered, how does your leg grow, or how do amoeba divide? These things might have made you curious. Today, let's learn about the biology behind it. The division or growth of cells is due to the process of mitosis or meiosis. Mitosis is a type of somatic cell division in which the mother cell divides into two genetically identical daughter cells. The cell first undergoes interphase, where the chromosomes in the nucleus replicate to generate two sets of DNA in the form of sister chromatids. During this, the cell faces two regulatory checkpoints. G1S restricts DNA replication when damaged DNA is detected, whereas G2M restricts cell division when damaged or unreplicated DNA is detected. After this, the cell enters M phase, which starts from the prophase, where the chromosomes start to condense, and the mitotic spindle is formed, which is made up of microtubules. Also, the nucleolus disappears, which is a sign that the nucleus is getting ready to break down. You might be confused about microtubules. These are proteins formed during cell division that attach to the chromosomes at the kinetochore protein present in the centromere of the chromosome. Also, note that the centromere is the structure where the sister chromatids of the chromosomes attach. Now the cell moves to the second stage, metaphase, where microtubules capture all the chromosomes and align them in the center of the cell at the metaphase plate. Two kinetochores of each chromosome attach to a microtubule, and the other end is attached to the aster, formed on the opposite spindle poles. Before entering the next stage, the cell faces the third checkpoint, the spindle assembly checkpoint, or SAC, which in response to microtubule defects ensures that chromosomes are accurately segregated and activated during the transition from metaphase to anaphase. Next, the cell enters anaphase, where the centromere of each chromosome divides transversely so that each half chromosome has its centromere. Now the sister chromatids are separated from each other and moving towards opposite ends of the pole. Finally, in telophase, the cell structures start reestablishing their nuclear membranes and nucleoli while chromosomes begin to decondense. After all of this, the cell undergoes cytokinesis. The cell membrane begins to contract, and a cleavage furrow is formed due to a protein called actin. In plants, the cleavage furrow is replaced by a cell plate for a stiff cell wall. Lastly, cell membranes are separated from the nucleus and all other cell organelles, and we have two independent cells. Remember, mitosis is an equational division where the number of chromosomes is restored, whereas meiosis is a reductional division in which the number of chromosomes is reduced to half in the daughter cells compared with the mother cell. Thus, amoeba and hydra, organisms that reproduce via asexual reproduction, are genetically similar because they follow mitotic cell division, whereas the human gametes are produced through meiosis, which results in genetic variation. In summary, we learn the process of the mitotic cell cycle, its stages, regulatory checkpoints, and mechanism. Thanks for watching.